Now here we are going with energy conservation in electric furnace. Okay, so to understand this concept, I am providing a link in the description for working of electric furnace. First go through that working of electric furnace. That thing will make clear how electric furnace works, and then the rest point are quite easy. Why for most of the points we are going with initial working and then energy conservation? Because whenever you understand the working of the product or working strategy or the theme line, you will understand where the energy is getting wasted or where we can save the energy, right? So it's important to understand working of this instrument, and then only we can go with the energy conservation. Now here in this diagram you can see there are different parameters. Okay, so in these parameters, so continue with the diagram. Here we can see electrical heating elements, then these are the coils. Sometimes initially there was a furnace system, electric means that was a old furnace. Now electrical furnace, these are the heating coils. Now air filter control means why we require air for proper heating the process. Then blower means what, to pressurize the air with a high. One thing keep in mind, there are blowers. The use of blower over here in electrical furnace is for exhaust, means sometimes you have to blow the air for exhaust the different types of gases, the flue gases we can say, so that the flue gases should not disturb the environmental condition of the electric furnace. And to make the blower work, definitely that is coupled with what, motor, right? Now how we can conserve energy in the electric furnace? First point, check against infiltration of air. Infiltration of air means what? Maximum the air which we are taking from the inlet should be oxygen, or it should be free of pollutant gases. Why? Because pollutant gases can damage the ecosystem of the furnace. Next point, then monitor O2, CO2, CO and control excess air to the optimum level. Now there are the recently we are dealing with a concept called as automation. So these are the all things which are done by automation. Right now we have the sensors which can sense different numbers of gases, and according to that they can give the alarm to the person who is handling that furnace, whether the system is working okay, the gas intake is okay or not. Point number three, improve burner design. Now burner design is the part and parcel of mechanical system. Recently there are many advancements going with the burner design, because what is the significance of burner design? That thus, if we are putting a material in the electric furnace, it should get heated from all the sides of its area. Means if it's a rectangular cube and we are putting a rectangular cube over here, over there in the electric furnace, so the heat reaches to each and every part of the rectangular cube should be same. And that is the significance of what, burner. Means the design of burner plays an important role in this. Then combustion control, definitely the heat required should be we should be able to control the heat provided to a specific material. Means whenever we require high heat, we can control it. Just it's a same scenario like gas. We use a gas cigarette at our home, at our domestic level, and we have the knob to control the flame. Same like then, here also we should have a combustion control and instrumentation, means the part which is able to control the combustion. Next point, ensure that the furnace combustion chamber is under slight positive pressure. Now positive pressure means pressure always plays an important role As far as the heating things are concerned, we know that due to pressure, the heat provided or the heating process can be faster, right? So this plays an important role. Next point, use ceramic fiber in the case of batch operation. Now, these ceramic fibers are used to provide the casing. Means if you want to put a rectangular cube, you can't just put it by your own bare hands in the furnace. Why? Because the furnace environment is quite heated. So you have to put the rectangular cube inside a ceramic frame, and then the ceramic frame will go inside the electric furnace. Okay. Next point, match the load to the furnace capacity. Now this is quite okay. Means don't overload the furnace, because if you put the material, or if you overload the furnace, definitely it will consume excess energy, and that is a malfunctioning for that oven, sorry, furnace. Next point, retrofit with heat recovery device. Again, the heat recovery system we already discussed in the oven. Then the heat which is getting wastage, we can, if it is possible, we can reutilize the same heat. It will be well and good. Next point, investigate cycle times and reduce energy loss. Means the cycle time means if we are heating the same material again and again, or the same slab of material, so after some times we understand that how much time it will take to heat a particular material to certain temperature. So we can fix the timing, we can fix the cycle. Definitely this will help to conserve the energy. This is a trial and this cycle times is a word which is done by trial and error method. If in industry you will visit and you can ask the person how much time it will take to produce a simple or a specific device or something, so he will let you know the exact time. Then you get surprised how that person knows. This is a trial and error method. For first 10 or 12 or 15 or 20 materials, that person calculate the time, how much time it is taking, and after that he get a fixed time that yes, this time is the required time to make this instrument. Next, provide temperature controllers. Yes, that's important, because the temperature varies according to the material. Every time it is not the same material which is going inside the furnace. The temperature should be we should able to fluctuate the temperature according to material. And last point, ensure that the flame does not touch the body of furnace. Now this is quite important. The flame should not touch the body of a furnace. Why? Because if that possible, it may possible that the furnace body can capture the fire. That is a very rare thing, because the material is so that it should not catch the fire. But the furnace material is made up of metal, and the metal will capture the heat, and that heat will be not going to utilize for any work. Means it's a waste. So we are here to conserve the energy, not to waste the energy. So these are the 10 points which we had covered under this energy conservation and electric furnace. Hope so you understand the point. If you have doubts, you can ask. Thank you.